Përshëndetje, jam Kun, and today I'm going to review the entry of Albania at Eurovision 2021, Angela Peristeri with the song Karma. Arilina Ara, who was chosen to represent Albania last year with the song Fall from the Sky, was not internally reselected to represent Albania at the Eurovision Song Contest this year. Instead, a new edition of Festivali I Këngës was held, of which the winner would get the opportunity to go to Eurovision. Arilina did not submit a song for this edition of Festivali I Këngës. The festival was held outdoors this time because of COVID, and damn, you could really see how cold it was. I mean, it was in December, so go figure. Angela Peristeri won the national final with her ballad Karma. She was seen as one of the big favorites of this year's edition to win, yet there were also some talks about it being rigged, and Gina Sufi, one of the contestants who did not qualify to the grand final, posted to her Instagram story, "Take some acting classes first before you receive the award," when Angela won the festival, which raised some questions by some people. After Angela won, it wasn't sure yet whether the song was going to be in English or not, but there was going to be a revamp. Later, Angela confirmed that the song was going to stay in Albanian, which made a lot of people happy, since Albania usually does better with Albanian songs, and also the Albanian revamps are overall more loved than the English ones. On the 1st of March, the revamp of Karma was released. This revamp did not really sound like a ballad anymore, but more like an experimental song with both modern and traditional sounds. I personally really like Karma. I already liked the song during the national final. I was also very happy to hear that the song was going to stay in Albanian, because I personally also prefer the Albanian entries of Albania in the past few years over most of the English ones. I think they did a pretty good job at the revamp. Sure, we've lost the only Balkan ballad we had this year, and a Eurovision year without a Balkan ballad feels pretty weird, but still, it is still a good song in my opinion. I like that it's a bit experimental with both the traditional sounds and the modern sounds, and I listened to it quite a lot actually. Seeing that Albania is performing in the second semi-final, which is the weaker one of the two, I'm already pretty positive about Albania's chances, and also Albania is placed in between Georgia and Portugal in the running order, which are two entries which I think can easily be overshadowed by Angela. I think despite Karma not being a ballad anymore, it still is pretty different from the rest of the entries because of its structure and the overall sound of the song. Also, Sacha Jean-Baptiste will do the staging of Albania this year, which I think is very promising. I'm very excited to see what the staging will look like. Also, I mean, Angela's voice. Now, come on now. So yeah, I'm pretty confident about Albania's chances. I'm not too sure how well Albania would do in the grand final. I think that would depend mostly on the staging, but a place in the grand final sounds like a pretty realistic achievement to me. So to conclude, I like Albania's entry this year. I'm happy that they kept the song in Albanian because they're usually more successful with entries in Albanian. I think Karma can stand out quite a lot, especially looking at the place in the running order and what semi-final they're competing in. I'm not sure where in the grand final I'd place her. I think that would depend mostly on the staging. And that's all for now. Let me know what you think of the song in the comment section down below. I want to thank you so much for watching, and hopefully until next time, Mirupavshim.